Parental discretion is advised.
I don't want to be a product of my environment. I want my environment to be a product of me.
Welcome to the Ritz-Kellogg Radio Show.
I'm Morgan Freeman, and you're listening to the Ritz-Kellogg Radio Show. Where you are right now is ridiculously awesome. Andy Dufresne. Andy?
Yeah, what the fuck kind of shit's going on, bro?
Yo.
I don't think anything works. I think this place is possessed. My computer's possessed. My phone's possessed. Everything I fucking own is possessed. I don't get it, man.
Hey, you know what?
We're just getting right into this right here. This is Koma and
some Frankenstein shit going on.
Koma and Gael Delarossa.
What do you do? How y'all doing?
Yeah, but you got to get a little louder up in the microphones, like for fucking vagina. No way to make this shit work. To make it, you want to hear your voice the way you would sound on the radio.
Yo, now you can.
There you go. Yo, you got to be like right up on that.
I'm right here.
Yeah, there you go. I can hear you now.
Okay, cool.
I don't understand why the music wasn't fucking working. I don't. Maybe they could hear it then. I don't think so. I think Spotify is trying to rob me as well.
I'm telling you.
Apple and Spotify are trying to jack my money.
They always try to do that.
Apple does, dude. They go straight into your account and take your shit, dog. Even if you have
automatic
no funds.
Payment,
if you have no funds, dude, and when the second that funds go in there, the bitches smell it. They go right after it. It's like, oh, fuck.
Especially now.
I forgot they were after me.
And you know how Apple, how they set it up now, because with the phones, now you got to buy more iCloud storage to back up your stuff, so they just set you up to, like, have to.
Oh, they just dropped my shit from 200 gigs to fucking 50. I don't.
They got you on the monthly now. Apple's smart. They hustled everybody. They're like, you need to get the phone.
Yeah, and they make the fucking shit break on purpose, so you have to pay them more money, bro.
You know how many
iPads? We're streaming live right now on fucking live.me.
Yeah.
I don't know how to find me on there, though, so don't even trip. Don't even worry about it. Don't worry about it. This is the Made You Listen show, Ritz-Kellogg Radio. So, yeah.
We here.
Gael just got back from Colombia, man.
Colombiano, si.
You drink a lot of coffee down there? They have good coffee, man?
Man, coffee out
there. About cocaine? Cocaine. I don't like Colombians, okay?
Hey, man.
Don't call me no stinky dishwasher.
I mean, I can't say too much about it, but what I can say is that the myths are
Pablo
not,
Escobar,
the
man.
Myths,
that's what I can
the
say.
The myths are real. The myths.
Dude, I know, dude, real. Because, okay, industry, dude, I go on there because I like, when I masturbate, I like somebody to, somebody to watch me. Yeah, I'm fucked up, bro, because I feel like busting a nut and just shooting it onto the carpet or wherever it goes. I feel like it's wasting it. Like it's not being seen by somebody else. So there's like no validation to that. That's 300 million fucking little fucking souls, bro.
It's some deep sickness. I got you.
300 million. So when I fucking, I pay like a new model. Most of them are Colombian or I fucking hate Russians. But the Colombian girls, man, they have the most beautiful women down there.
Yeah,
and I had so many conversations with me bringing them up here.
Yeah.
They want me to go down there. I'm like, fuck, you're going to get killed down there and get a Colombian necktie.
I mean, yeah, out there, you
I don't want to get Colombian necktie.
There's a big American myth out there that, you know, Colombia is still Pablo Escobar and there's a bunch of cocaine and you can go out there and get
I saw this show on
and
Netflix.
If you're American, don't go there.
It's
your
called
life is gonna
Dark Tourist.
Yeah.
And there's this tour. You could go down there and take a tour with Pablo Escobar's fucking hitman guy.
His actual guy.
Yeah. He has like a YouTube show and shit.
Yeah. Because when I went there, actually,
this guy's making money off of showing off Pablo's shit.
I saw Pablo's crib because I went to Cologne. It's like
he had more than one.
He had a few, but this specific crib that he had was about 60 miles outland from Cartagena, so he had like a little like island that he like made into his fortress. So it was like a full-on fucking island.
An island?
He had a plane.
A fucking island? Like that lady, the Colombian Grammy Award winner?
He had a fucking island.
That was Pablo's before hers?
Yes. Pablo had another island that was his that he built. He put a
they like buying islands over there. How much are islands down there?
I have no idea. But I did see
a couple
that.
Million. I'll tell you this right now. A couple hundred million.
No, but I was
a
really,
million?
Brother. It's amazing when you really look at that shit. Like to see Pablo's crib.
I wasn't even considered Colombia. Wait, is it now? It's still considered the waters off of Colombia. Yeah, so it's Colombia.
It's within 80 miles, but it's about 65 miles.
So
out.
If you go out further than that, you could. What would it be considered? You'd be your own government.
It'd probably be a different territory of some sort. I don't know the logistics of that shit. But you know. I mean, you know, you want me to get on my smart shit.
I don't know. I'm just curious myself, dude. I'm not trying to test you. I'm just curious. I thought maybe if you...
Nah, bro. Colombia is a special place. Americans think that, you know, it's a place not to go to because of the, you know, narcos and all our TV shows we got. But
They do craft. One of the most addictive fucking drugs on the planet.
I mean, that is true.
A lot of people's lives get fucked up because of Colombia.
They're trying to...
I'm not saying it's the people of Colombia's fault.
Well, pause. That's the old viewpoint, though, because the
Colombia, there's always a good guy. Because,
like,
I mean, the cops are really...
Narcos, all that shit.
No. The Colombian police or army are really looking to stop the cocaine traffic coming out of there. But the thing is, that it won't stop. Get it. No, but you always have the bad guy. There's one guy that's in there. He's the one that fucking like gives the heads up on the people, and they always bone out before they get hit by the fucking army.
Oh yeah, like the official.
Because when they go to raid them,
yeah,
they have a microwave in there, like just some bullshit.
Yeah.
They're out there in the middle of the jungle, dude, like getting electricity to these little fucking huts and shit.
I mean, they do say though in Cartagena, which is off the coast, don't leave the city walls at night, which means you know once you leave the tourist area, it's wild. So you know. Don't get me wrong. It's still Colombia.
You will get your head cut off.
It's still Colombia. Don't
fucking
get me wrong.
Fucking gringo.
But
you're not gringo, but they'll be a PG gringo.
Yeah, you know what?
I'm going to give you a Colombian necktie.
You know why I love Colombia? I fit right in. I go there. I'm like, I could be Colombian because I look Colombian. I'm not Colombian, by the way, but I look Colombian with the people.
No, Colombians look like everybody. They look like white. You have black Colombians.
You got black. You got white.
Yeah, it's a plethora. You have a plethora of people.
It's the real Latino shit, like Puerto Ricanos.
You have white people that speak Spanish now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that are fucking.
Oh, yeah. You have white Colombians, black Colombians.
Yeah.
Everyone's
mixed. Like America.
You see those.
You have Asian Colombians.
You see those, like, you see those tan.
That should be funny, huh? Seeing an Asian chick speaking Spanish and shit?
That is a trip.
That'd be funny.
You see those caramel.
Is there an Asian girl down there?
There's Asian people out there, but it's not really considered Colombian. The real Colombian is that, like, caramel skin with, like, blonde hair and, like, green.
Blonde hair.
They exotic because there's so many
different. No, it's fake. Yeah,
so
fake hair.
No,
fake blonde.
So many different bloodlines.
They have black-ass hair, bro.
You see
the
some,
real Colombians.
You'll see some crazy. Dude, I've seen some literally, like, they're orange.
But the real, real Colombian. Beans,
with green eyes,
thick ass, hair.
Nah, bro, it's different because
it's bristles. I used to cut my homeboy's hair, dude. That shit would like fucking give me splinters.
Don't label because you got to keep in mind. Just like here in America, there's different. There's same in Colombia.
I know. It's just like Jamaica. People don't know that about Jamaica. You go to Jamaica, you have Asian people that speak a patois and shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They're like, Wagwan man. What the fuck you said, Japanese, bro? Konnichiwa. No, Wagwan, brother. Fuck you, fucking.
I mean, like we were talking about earlier, you know, these countries, you know, like Colombia, South America, these places, they're so much more ahead with lifestyle. You know, here in America, we have so many problems. We got these mass murders. We got these crazy motherfuckers killing niggas, doing all types of
crazy right here, five-minute drive?
5 miles away, we had a fucking high school kid come through the high school and
saga
kill
shooting,
two kids.
Saga shooting.
And shit. All this crazy shit.
But this is like the town that shit would have happened in, though.
I mean, yeah, that's a fact. But look, the
shit happens in white America.
No, but the bottom, it's not even white America.
This is like Asian America, though.
Bro, all these mass shootings, all this gun violence, all the crazy shit, it does not happen in other places in the world. It only happens here in America. And
I think the Chinese are about to break down on us, dude.
It's Hong Kong, bro. Hong Kong is going to war, bro, because they.
No, I bet you they're going to break out some.
Oh, it's going, bro. Did you see the shooting?
We take it over LA. We want LA. Australia.
Did you see the fucking cop take the dude, shoot the dude? The dude was bleeding out. He grabbed him by his back.
Where, in Hong Kong?
In Hong Kong, was grabbed.
Oh, the Chinese government's trying to take him back over?
No, no, no. You didn't see this, bro?
Dude, I don't watch the news, bro. You know why? Because it's
Chinese. No, look, listen.
Because I don't have cable TV. And all they watch here, is sports.
No, this is real shit. This Hong Kong cop, he had a protester in his, he was holding him, and the guy was resisting or whatever. He had a gun in his hand, and he was telling him, stop resisting, and there's people and crowds around everywhere, people all next to him and everything. It was the Chinese cop. And then the guy kept moving, so he just takes him and just pops him right next to him. He's like, pop, pop, right there.
Head?
No, in the side. And he starts bleeding out, and he's dragging him. And everyone's like, what the fuck? Like, what are you doing? And he's just like, get away. Everyone, back up. You know, typical
Titanic
shit. The guy's bleeding out. He's holding him by his back. He looked like a stray dog. Like, he's holding a
dog. They did that shit. No, look, they did that shit. My boy was down in Beverly Hills. Well, they did that shit to somebody.
Look, you don't understand, in Asia, bro, they don't show emotion, and they're very inside with everything. So when you see these things in such a broad scale in these places, the impact it has on the culture and the people is in a deeper scale than it would have here.
But you have to know what's going on over there in China, too, though. They're killing millions of people.
No, but it's Hong Kong.
Right, right. It was a British.
Hong Kong specifically is trying to stay its own.
Great Britain fucking made its own thing.
It's fighting for its democracy right now, basically. But what I'm saying, though, is that...
They closed shop, bro.
No, and then...
It's like the DDR.
Look, and then after that...
The strongest will survive,
look,
right?
Listen. Then after that cop went and did that, you know what the people did?
They got the cop and shot him?
No, no. There was another protest going on another day. And this one protester guy, he was for the Chinese government. And he was talking about, you know, the Hong Kong people. They're fucking stupid. Talking shit. And this guy just lights his ass on fire. This guy just they throw gasoline on him while he's talking
to this cop.
No, it's just
a Chinese.
He's a sympathizer of the Chinese government, basically.
Sympathizer
living in Hong Kong.
Fuck a sympathizer.
So they throw fucking lighter fluid on him and they light his ass on fucking
fire.
Kill him. This is on camera. This is all you can watch this on YouTube.
Okay,
right
I'm
now.
Gonna watch that yeah, shit.
Both of these videos that I just stated, you can watch.
What has
on
happened
YouTube.
Recently?
This happened in the last month and a half. It happened while I was in Thailand, actually. And my boy Bucky, he's my brother. He's an Asia like expat. He was sending me all this shit live. It was happening, bro.
I bet you that's been banned from fucking.
I don't think so, bro. Maybe it has been, but that
people
shit
getting lit on
mind,
fire
bro.
And shot. I don't think they have that.
Dude,
on
they
right.
lit his ass
Maybe
on, fire.
On Live Leak.
No, they lit his ass on fire.
Live Leak has that fucking.
And this motherfucker's like this, and this nigga's like this, just floating around and shit. And they douse his ass with water.
You can still watch the two Mexicans dudes. Die on Live Leak. Mm. You know the
all those weird websites and shit.
The guy with the chainsaw and the dull knife. Those two good dudes.
I never seen that shit.
Yeah, you have.
No,
you never seen the guy die with the chainsaw.
I don't like gory shit. To be
bro,
honest,
bro, it's not that gory. It's just watching these guys die, though. It's like a trip to watch it.
I don't
the
like
sound effects fuck
die,
with you. I don't
honest.
Really like to see them either, but
I don't like
it
that
makes you
shit.
Respect life more.
I mean. I've seen dead
and
people.
And the message
don't
is don't fucking don't I've snitch. Seen, don't snitch.
Man. Yeah, I just try to stay away from that. That should be making me negative and shit. I'm trying to be
honest. It's good to see
shit.
That shit though, man. I showed somebody once on a podcast.
Bro.
We went to a song and came back and my boy fucking Chris Watts and it was yeah. Damien and Chris Watts. And Damien fucking watched
man.
It and he was losing his mind, dude.
Bro, that shit just brings me down, bro. When I watch that weird shit.
Fuck those dudes. They've been dead over 10 years, bro.
Like, motherfuckers be like, oh, yeah. Like,
it's not new.
Watch this shit.
It's old.
Like, I'll be honest, man. Especially in this day and age with all the shit they be putting on TV.
You ever watch Faces of Death?
I be feeling like I be getting brainwashed with everything. Like, from
you ever watch Faces of Death?
I just be trying to keep my mind clean, huh?
You ever watch Faces of Death?
Faces of Death. What's that?
That's where they kill, like cows. They hit a little monkey over the head, and then they eat the brains and shit.
What the fuck?
It's old, dude. We used to get stoned and watch that shit and laugh. But it was sick, dude. They're killing, like, cows and, like, sheep. And it's a bunch of crazy videos.
Whoa.
Yeah.
That's a trip.
Yeah. We used to get high and, like, have no fucking, like, heart.
Nah, that's when I was a kid and I used to watch that weird shit of those dogs fucking...
Fucking women
fucking
and shit.
Women and shit.
Go down.
Be like, what the fuck
yeah, dude, cultures are weird, bro.
Fucking horses, and these bitches would be taking horses. I'm like, damn.
That's really happening right now in Mexico, bro. The donkey shows.
Hey, that's some weird, crazy shit.
They be pimping. That's worse than
out there.
That's you pimping. Know, that's know, pimping you, a bitch you, hardcore.
You know, you
putting her on a stage, bro. She has no shame,
you
dude.
Call that a fucking mutant, dog. It's not even a human anymore.
for a woman to do that, for that to even be legal, how come the government's not stopping that?
That's sick. That needs to be abolished by every means.
Yeah, they should hang these people.
Yeah, that's sick.
And then
sick.
Shoot the girl on fire, light her on fire. That should, throw her into a fucking, like a shark infested water.
You have the balls to put your ass getting...
Face down, ass up, and get fucked by a donkey.
An animal dog.
Or a fucking animal.
Or something. You gotta have a mental problem, for sure. You gotta be sick in the head. Like, truthfully, you,
little girls I don't care sucking what on their fetish, dog's dick.
I don't care what fetish.
I bet you right now there's some little girl sucking on her dog's dick.
Don't say
dick.
That. Don't say those sick things.
You right sick now, motherfucker. In this big ass world.
Shut your ass up, nigga. You talking
Do
about?
Do you know right now someone's dying on the dark web?
Sick. Someone's dying on the dark
web. I swear there's probably someone sucking a dog's dick on the dark web.
Oh, God. Lord Jesus. Bless my soul. I'm just
bless the beautiful world that you made. Shit, Jesus, bless the beautiful world that you made. Because it needs blessing. Like, tell your pops, Jesus, please to fucking have another flood, dude.
Oh, me, oh, my. Hey.
Nah, flood this bitch.
Hey, but on real talk, real talk, you
man-made
know,
weather can flood us.
We wonder why all these mass murders happen and these crazy manifestos and these motherfuckers doing all this crazy weird shit here in America and it doesn't happen anywhere else in the world. It's because dudes here in America are sexually frustrated. And when I say that, I'm not trying to say all men have issues. What I'm saying is that there's a lot of men. Like, you seen the movie The 40-Year-Old Virgin? You've seen the 40-year-old virgin, the movie, right?
Yeah.
There's a lot of men like that in real life. Like,
that don't get pussy. No, of course there are. Of course there are.
No, but that whole manifest. No, listen.
That's a cam model industry. The majority of people watching that
shit. Not even about fuck cam model. I'm talking about just the overall American guy.
They don't socialize.
Like the regular American guy that doesn't got the skeezo, doesn't have the swag.
Right.
That does. It's just a regular guy.
Right.
Just when he goes to the club and he talks to a girl, he tells his homies, oh, bro, this girl talked to me. And, you know, like, that's a big deal for him. It makes him so happy. It's like,
same thing. Men
here in America, a majority of them that don't got the steelo, and not to down talk any man, but some got it, some don't. The majority of that is so high here in America, these motherfuckers go crazy. These motherfuckers are sexually frustrated. They go fucking psycho and they fucking blow shit up, start shooting everybody.
Yeah.
Only here in America.
Go to Colombia.
Not even Colombia, just the world in general, bro.
Go to Colombia and you won't be sexually frustrated.
It's just.
Everybody that's out there that doesn't get any pussy, every man. Just take a trip to Thailand or Colombia.
Nah, I don't even think that. Because to be honest,
they still won't get pussy, you're saying?
Nah, the quality of life out there is just better. If you're looking for...
Are you saying they won't get pussy?
Look.
Hey, go to the club. What was the club you went to? What is it?
No, I'll keep it real with
you. What was that club you went to?
This is real talk. If you're looking for that and like you're trying to get on that and you need to do that, okay. Yeah, you can have a good time and it's a lot different than
just go pay for a hooker, dude.
Yeah, fuck all that shit. We don't pay for it. I know,
I don't either. But if they have to get laid, they should pay for it.
I ain't paying for shit.
If they want to fuck, pay the buck.
I ain't paying.
I'm not telling you. I'm talking about them.
Yeah.
Talk about the dudes that make a lot of money. They're like ugly, or they feel have really like low self esteem issues.
Yeah, don't get me
wrong. They're socially inadequate. They fucking probably have Asperger's.
Don't get me wrong. I know dudes, a lot of homies that get down like that. I know people who do that, but we don't.
But it's sad, dude. They end up fucking men then.
But it's not even that. These motherfuckers go crazy. Here in America, we got all these crazy shootings and these dudes writing these manifestos and talking about how they hate the world and they want to fuck everyone and shoot everybody. It's because these motherfuckers, their dicks ain't getting hard. These motherfuckers is stressed. I heard you lose it if you don't use it. America sex and sexuality is such a taboo thing out here and so put into such
a... Because Americans are a bunch of pussies, bro. Words like midget and retard.
I don't give a fuck
They're
about
too worried
being
about stupid
correct.
Shit.
I don't give a
Me
fuck.
Neither. Because I'll say those
saying,
words.
What I'm saying is, though, in general, though, like, you know, Americans, you know... Like sexuality is such a taboo thing.
No, it is.
Like, motherfuckers be sitting in their computer watching porn all day and writing dirty thoughts
and feelings,
and then they want to go and make these feelings happen, and then they go shoot somebody. Like,
yeah, go shoot up like Santa Barbara College, the University of Santa Barbara.
America's the only place that has weird shit like that happen, and everyone's got guns all over the world. So it's pretty funny how we always do that dumb shit. And I don't think we should take guns away either. That ain't the answer.
No, dude. Everybody should be packing heat. We're in Los Angeles, baby.
That ain't the answer. But pack that heat, there's baby. A reason why these motherfuckers is going lunatico. You feel me? There's a
lunatico.
Reason. There's a reason behind that shit. Motherfuckers.
El lunatic.
Not everybody's got the steez, bro. And some and these motherfuckers aren't able to release themselves. They go crazy and start doing all this weird shit. Motherfuckers is sexually frustrated. Sexually frustrated.
Sexually
That's
frustrated.
That's my hypothesis.
They probably put peanut butter on their fucking...
That is my Gooch. Hypothesis. My, my
have the dogs lick it.
That's my thing, bro. Hey, after really looking at that shit, motherfuckers is sexually frustrated, bro. Oh. And these niggas going out shooting motherfuckers. It's
shooting
crazy.
Motherfuckers.
When you start traveling, bro, and seeing how other countries don't even think to do something of that nature and how we just so quickly do that, that lets you know there's a problem. There's something wrong in our society that causes this to happen. Feel me?
Yeah.
I don't know what it is, but I feel that's the answer. I might not be right. That's my opinion. You feel me?
I feel you, dog. That's
you
some shit right
me,
there.
You feel me?
What else were we talking about? We were talking about some other shit we were going to say we were going to talk about on here. My brain is just like melting.
Yeah, I know. I'm pretty stoned.
Yeah.
I'm pretty blown.
What else were we saying? Oh, dude, what the fuck is that? Bing, so bing, bing.
They're dinging us, bro. They're like... They're like, you went too
I'm not even paying attention to what's being said over there. What's up, people over there? It's a fucking live me. What's going on? We didn't forget. We're just in our conversation talking. Because we don't want to get a Colombian necktie.
Yeah, we're talking some bullshit. Hey.
What's up with George? He got arrested the other day.
Who, George got arrested?
Yeah.
No, he didn't, bro.
George got arrested.
What did he get arrested for?
Well, Ryan got him out of here.
Wait, what did he get arrested for?
Ryan, he came in here. He had a drink from Black and Blue in
George
his hand.
George got, little Georgie got arrested. Aw.
Yeah, but no, but then he was asked to leave here. So Ryan escorted him over to the Hyatt across the street.
Escorted his ass to the Hyatt.
And then a bunch of cop cars were there.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Yeah, hey, nigga.
And I saw him in the back seat getting hauled off. Later, bye-bye.
Really?
Oh, yes.
You know, poor George.
And I texted him and called him. He didn't answer. He hasn't responded to me.
He's probably still locked up.
Hell no. Drunk in public. They let him out the next day. Then he said he was going to Dubai. Like, who's liar, like, dude? He's,
maybe he is.
I bumped into Elizabeth last night.
He's got two whips.
I bumped into Elizabeth last
was
night.
Who was the girl Elizabeth. Sleeping in the bed when he put
Elizabeth.
It on live? He put it on live. He put a girl sleeping in the bed. That's and funny. He didn't show her face.
When?
This is like... I was in Colombia when I saw that shit.
Oh,
like
recently?
4 days ago. Yeah, like 3-4 days ago. I was like, what the fuck?
Well, I bumped into Elizabeth. And I told her, I was trying to get her to get it.
Hey, stop, man. You're such a bad guy. You're on live. You're on my live, too, dog. Be careful what you say.
Oh, your live's off. Why did it go?
Oh, it's on, motherfucker.
Fuck. Damn. I don't give a fuck. I'm being honest, though. I wouldn't tell him anything different, dude. They're not together, right? But does he love her?
He probably does, maybe.
He doesn't, because he says straight up, that bitch owes me $15,000, like, right in front of her and shit. He's mean. He's a mean man.
No,
and he told me he was going to help me get a computer. Then he went to fucking Dominican Republic, and he fucking came back, right? And he didn't come. He helped me get a computer.
No, because...
He said, when I get back, I'll help you.
It's part of the culture. Think about where he's from, and I'll be honest... His
what do you mean? How did I do? Give me a computer?
Nah, because you said how he treats Liz like shit. The culture, even when I go to Thailand and some of these countries, like the views of that culture are not the best.
Me have that ass.
Just because they're very rude to the women and don't treat women very nice. You know?
Yeah, man. It's not cool, dude. Nah. Just like the fucking Taliban, dude, covering their women's faces.
Yeah, it's fucked up, dude. It's fucked up.
But you know what, dude? Eddie Murphy did his Raw stand-up. He did Raw. That shit was funny, dude. He was talking about a friend had like an Asian fucking like wife, and then she just bowed and shit. Like he look over at, he'd ask like the friend. He would ask the like friend like a question. Hey, dude, like she did it, and then he looks at the wife, and
she's just like,
and he goes, yes, you may speak.
Oh my
he was talking God. About getting a fucking go to Africa and find a girl and have with a bone in her nose, and then like she didn't know English and then she hang out with his fucking friends and he's like, Eddie, I need to talk to you.
Oh, fuck.
You don't treat me right, Eddie.
Oh, fuck. Fucking Eddie, I miss Eddie.
No, because he was talking about Johnny Carson, dude, like going through his divorce, dude, and his wife taking half his money, $200 million.
Oh shit.
So when you You look at like half of your shit, like, you know, if you have $400 million, $200 million is a lot of money, but half of your shit, you have, when you have $5,
ain't shit.
They're taking $250 from you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I feel you. That's crazy.
It's a little bit different.
That's a trip, bro. I put that on.
No, divorces are fucked up, dude, in that like high, like George Clooney, I think he's going through one, isn't he?
Oh, yeah, he just got married a few years ago, too.
That motherfucker's a dumbass. He waited that long to fucking get married to some bitch?
Yeah, it's already going down the hill. I haven't seen George Clooney.
You know who's back
alive.
With Jennifer Aniston's back with Brad Pitt.
What?
Yeah. He moved back in that bitch's house.
Wait, he moved into her house?
That's what I saw on the paper, in the fucking magazine.
No.
It's on the cover of like a good magazine, like Us Weekly or...
Yeah,
it's not Enquirer. Yeah, you know, it's not funny. The Enquirer.
Jennifer Aniston will always be bad.
I bet you she does anal,
she's
dude.
She's so fine. No, because I remember, bro, I saw her.
Angelina guaranteed does anal, dude.
Angelina Jolie?
Fuck yeah.
She's a fucking sick motherfucker.
But no, but she's a crazy bitch, bro.
She got them DSL lips.
But no, dude. She would have been good. She would have been good back in the day, bro. But now she's an older, like, older woman, wants to do
she's
shit for the world.
Super freak.
No, but she was with Billy Bob Thornton, dude.
Oh, Billy Bob?
Oh, dude, they drink each other's blood. They were fucking in the limo on the way to the Oscars.
Yeah, they
drew were freaks, dude.
Yeah, I already know.
I know his son, dude.
His son lives out here.
Yeah, I know. He used to be a security guard at the place I lived.
That's so weird that his son used to fucking...
And I could blame his son for me getting arrested for that weapons charge because he's the one that had that telescope fucking baton.
Dude, Billy
and
Bob's
I wanted
son,
one, so I bought one.
Dude, Billy Bob's son, dude, he's known as such a little fucker out here.
I follow him on Instagram. No, he's cool, dude. He rides bike. He wanted to become a Marine and then he wanted to become a cop and shit.
He driving around in a black cop car? He bought an old Crown Royal and then he was fucking driving around in it.
I don't know, dude, but the thing is, I'm like, why would you want to do that, bro? First off, he was sitting there talking to a neighbor, right? And he said something about his dad being an actor. And I was like, your dad's an actor? Who's your dad? He goes, oh, you probably don't know who he is. And I was like, shoot. And he goes, Billy Bob Thornton. I go, I said, get the fuck out of here, dude. And he showed me his fucking name tag, Thornton. I was like, get the fuck out of here. Your dad's not just an actor. He's a fucking A-lister. He's fucking, he directed, he's
it's
Sling Blade.
It's kind of weird how Billy Bob's an A-lister because
he's
a
A-listed
in a weird way.
He did Sling Blade, bro. Like, he's Sling Blade. Like, your dad wrote, directed, and starred in that film.
That was a weird-ass movie.
I reckon, he's like, okay, I reckon,
fucking creepy. He's a fucking pervert when you.
Well. Dude, he was with Angelina. Dude.
Yeah.
And then he had that scene with fucking Halle Berry. Ooh, Monsters Ball.
I'll never forget when I saw that shit as a kid. I was like, wow. I think they were really fucking.
She probably takes anal, dude.
I think
they
really,
all take anal,
I
dude.
Think they were really fucking in that movie.
They love anal.
I don't think it was fake. That looked real.
I don't like it. I'm not an anal dude anymore.
I
used to fuck around in like my early 20s. Like my 20s, I was about like coming. Like I came, I saw, I conquered. Like all their like orifices.
Oh man!
But then now I had two girls leave me a present in 1 year.
Oh no!
You know what I mean? I screamed the first time.
Oh no! Never! Oh my god! Oh, don't even stop!
It's just
stop,
poo,
bro.
But it was scary, dog.
You're sickening me right now.
Yeah, it was all up in that tip.
All up in that.
I screamed, dude. I screamed, bro. I swear I jumped.
Stop.
I swear I jumped on my sink.
That's
I jumped on my sink like a wolf.
Oh, that's sick.
Like a wolf
that's
man.
Sick.
Ah! Oh. I turned the water on.
It's some sickness.
It dipped in the water like this.
The sickness right there. That's some dirty dogging right there.
On the real, the second person to leave some shaman dick was Searing's cousin.
Womp, womp, womp. You sick bastard.
I know.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I mean, okay.
I know his cousin for like 20 years.
Is she hot?
Nope. She used to be like whatever, just a little hole, like a homie hopper.
Now she's a beezer.
Now she's like gaining a lot of weight.
She's gotten skeezed out. Yep.
She told me one time I fucked her for 6 hours. No shit. I fucked her for 6 hours. Okay. This is so bad. Okay. We were talking about getting down and dirty into some conversation about this shit. Okay. This is bad.
For 6 hours.
Listen to me. 6 hours, bro. Like, I could not come. I was dripping sweat all over the place, bro.
Oh, I've been there.
Dude, I could not come. Dude, she has no walls, bro. Okay, look.
She's got a whiffle?
Dude, in her pussy? or in right, her, just, or hey, in her butt, hey, or in her butt, bro. No, no, no. No, or in her butt, bro. Look, look, listen to me.
She's a whiffle.
I put it in her butt. I was in her butt. Whiffle. I had to reach around. I reached around her front. I reached around the front. I went, I am in your butt. I am in your butt. And I was like, how did this? She didn't shit on my dick this time. The next time she did. But
that's sick.
I know it's disgusting. Disgusting. Trust me. Trust me. It's so just not cool. Bastard. And they seem like they're not even embarrassed. It's weird.
Dude,
it's like,
dude,
you fucked with it, you know? Like, I guess so.
The only
but,
thing that happened to me is when I did it, and after so, on the rub, I smelled all the shit.
So
I was like,
I reached around, bro. Like, this bitch has no walls. She has no walls, dude. And then when I was done fucking her, I finally busted a nut, dude. And she goes, I don't want to make you have a big head, Tommy, but that was the best sex I've ever had. I'm like,
6 hours worth, bitch. Dude, you better be the best you ever had in your fucking lifetime.
One time, she was at my pad, dude, and I had this pocket rocket. I bought this girl a pocket rocket, right?
A pocket rocket.
I bought it for her, and she left it, dude. It was in my pad, dude. So my buddy Adam and I were at the pad, and she was on my bed. So we start fucking with her titties and shit, and he was sucking on her titty, and I was pinching her nipple, and she had her nipples pierced, so I'm twisting her nipples. So I broke out the fucking pocket rocket, right? And I put it in her pussy. Bro, it was on full blast, like fucking, like crazy, like, right? Dude, it fucking went so far up in her, bro, I couldn't get to it.
It stayed stuck in
her? Bro, no. I finally, like, the game operation, bro, I fucking got it, like barely got it, dude. I pulled it out, and it was, she didn't know it was in there, dude.
That's disgusting, dude.
Dude, it was full blast, dude, and then it was still on.
So she's a whiffle.
I don't know.
She could probably fist herself.
Dude, that's what I'm saying. Like, did her shit, probably when her shit showed up at her butthole, when she, after she's eating or whatever, she gets a shit, did it just fall out of her butt?
Dude, she probably, no lie, she probably is one of those girls that you find on Two Girls, One Cup, you know, like double fisting themselves and all that weird.
Her good friend is Ashley Fires, a porn star. One time, I'm at the Buddha Lounge, and fucking, she comes up to me, and she grabs my dick, and she goes, Tommy, she's married, but, you know, her husband must be a cuckold, because she used to live where I lived, and she used to walk around the house naked, put on porn that she was in, and it was all girl on girl, but now she does, like, gangbangs with black dudes. It's like, dude, she's gone away, like, way from just girl on girl to, and she's older now, fuck, dude, she's still doing this shit, but. Her husband must be a cuckold for sure, like must get off on watching her.
Yeah, I couldn't get off on that.
But yeah, so
it would just mentally scar me.
So anyway, she grabs my dick. She grabs my dick at the club, and she goes, "Tommy, do me a favor. Can you fuck my friend?" And I'm like, "Who's your friend?" And she goes, "Laura," and then that's it. And I go, "I've been there, dude. I'm cool." I'm
so
cool.
Cousin for real? Damn.
Yeah, the one time we were out here pressure washing the front of the restaurant, I was streaming on like this, but on Facebook, and she was watching, I guess, and she goes, "Is that my cousin?" And I didn't do the math. Her name Wilson, the last name Wilson. So I'm like, Laura Wilson. I'm all, "Damn, that's your cousin. Damn, that's a trip." Yeah, they're rich. They got mad money.
Their family's rich. Serena.
Fucking super money.
Stupid
money. I didn't understand that when she was like, "Oh, don't worry, Laura's dad will get it." Because they fucking straight, like, over at River Ranch in Canyon Country, they stole all the fucking laundry machines and shit, dude.
Who did?
Dude, I don't know. Her and her people, they're all fucking twacked out, bro.
Oh, dude.
Smoking tweaks, bro.
Yeah?
Yeah, big time. They're bad tweakers.
Oh, his side, his cousins and shit?
His cousin, that what is.
That's fucked up.
I was like, dude, that's dude, y'all people are disgusting. But they stole all the fucking appliances, bro.
Damn.
And then, like, don't worry. It was all in Laura's name, dude. So Laura, she's like, "Oh, her dad will cover it." She, like, raped the pad and left.
Wait, it's her brother? It's Serene's.
Her dad, no. Her dad is Searing's
uncle.
I don't know how it is, dude. No, it's her grandfather's youngest, oldest son, or...
They got, how much money they got? Like, old
fucking
money?
$500 million? Or no. They've split it? I think his dad got $150 million.
Serene's dad?
Yeah.
So that's why Serene, this is like a joke for him, this place.
They bought, he was drunk one night. He said, "They bought me a job." But he compromised it. He compromised the restaurant because his dad said he was going to put like $300,000 into fixing, like, you know, upgrading it. And his sister's an architect, and his cousin, his cousin's a kitchen designer.
So why didn't they do it?
He didn't go through. His dad didn't. He bought it. Well, it doesn't make sense, though. Your dad bought the restaurant, but didn't go through with upgrading it. He wanted you to see you fail? Why would he invest his money to watch you fail?
They're that rich, they don't give a fuck.
That, I mean, he goes, he's my dad. So my dad just compromises everything. I'm like, fuck.
That's, you got that much money to buy $1 million business,
dude, I mean, this place,
and play around with it.
Dude, this is like prime location. Dude, all he needed to do is invest money, change this motherfucker up. This is Hovick's restaurant still, like the way it looks.
Yeah.
I mean, I've knocked out booths. I painted the place. I got to touch the paint up.
It needs to be remodeled.
No, like knock out builders and shit.
No, but the whole thing needs to be redone, dude.
You put the bar over here, bro. Half of it, like, inside and out, so the window.
That's what it was supposed to be. That was the plan.
And then you add, like, fucking, like, an upstairs area up here.
Yeah, but it's done. That ain't nothing going to happen now, dude. Serene's going to try to sell it.
No, but Serene's not going to fucking, like, he's not going to take less than what he paid for it. So, like, he's not going to go out like that. I don't think Serene's not, like, going to lose like that.
So he's just going to bury himself until he wins.
He's got to do something. I installed the new air fresheners in the bathroom. Like, buy some D batteries, dude, an air freshener.
Yeah, like,
do that kind of shit.
He's even buy any of that stuff.
I just need 4D. I need 4D batteries, bro.
Fuck, dude.
Just put them in there, bro. Because have you ever smelled a woman's bathroom?
Have you smelled like hoo ha in there?
Go smell that motherfucker.
Now it's fresh.
No. I haven't been in there. I haven't walked in there yet, dude.
I don't
even, it stinks so bad, bro. I used all the fucking air freshener they have, dude, I think. I spray it, like, on the walls. I spray it, like, anywhere, like, people can... No, it's that sewer. There's just something in the sewer, bro, or something down there.
Oh,
I don't know why we're talking about this, but, yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty sick.
Looked
at our shit. I'm curious.
We started talking about shit, now we're talking about... A lot of people. How many people stay up there? Follow him back. People are following?
Oh, yeah.
Following or joining?
Yeah, a lot of people. I guess you got a follower here.
Just tell him, hey, tell him, get the follow on. We'll follow you back. Just our cat. Hold up. Wait a minute. Let me put on some music for y'all real quick. We'll be right back. You know how this shit goes. It's a Ritz-Kellogg motherfucker radio show. What do we got here? What can I give you? What can I give you? Here we go. I'll give you something from here. Oh, check it out. Here's Future featuring Jake. Life is good.
Someone hit your block up, I'd tell you if it was us. Man, I... Wine by the glass, your man, a cheapskate, huh? Just gotta move off my release day, huh? I don't even know what that's about. Watch your mouth. Got an ego twice as... I can never tell a shit, it is what it is. Said what I... Never turn my back on FBG, God forbid. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist, doing front flips. Giving you my number, but don't hit me on no dumb shit. Working on a weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual.
Hold up, man. I'm gonna start that shit over for y'all. Yeah, because it was fucked up. Check it out, Ritz-Kellogg Radio.
working on a weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual. Niggas swear they passed us, they doing too much. Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts. Niggas caught me slipping once, okay, so what? Someone hit your block up, I tell you if it was us. Man, a house in Rosewood, this shit too plush. Say my day's a number, but I keep waking up. No, you see my text, baby, please say something. Wine by the glass, your man a cheapskate, huh? Niggas gotta move off my release day, huh? Bitch, this is fame, not clout. I don't even know what that's about, watch your mouth. Baby, got an ego twice the size of the crib. I can never tell a shit, it is what it is. Said what I had to and did what I did. Never turn my back on FBG, God forbid. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist, doing front flips. Giving you my number, but don't hit me on no dumb shit. Working on a weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual. Niggas swear they passed us, they doing too much. Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist, going nuts. Niggas caught me slipping once, okay, so what? Someone hit your block up, I tell you if it was us. Man, a house in Rosewood, this shit too plush.
It's cool, plush. Man. Got red bottoms on. Life is good. You know what I mean? Like,
100,000 for the cheapest ring on the nigga finger, little bitch. Ooh. I done flew one out to Spain to be in my domain, automata, bitch. Ooh. Dropped $3 on the rain, called it Bennett truck, little bitch. Ooh. I was in the trap, serving cocaine, they ain't been the same since. Ooh. Granted, she was standing right there while I catch play on the brick. Ooh. I made them little niggas go haywire, Taliban in this bitch. Ooh. I'd have been down bad in them trenches, had to ride with that stick. Ooh. Who gave you pills? Who gave that dust? Pluto sent you on the lick. Ooh. Too many convicts, they enrolled me to play in this shit. Ooh, round about nonsense, get old, so I'm spreading this bitch.
Yeah, dude.
I can bust a freestyle at the end.
Oh, okay, we can do that, dude. We'll kill the show. You know what? He just got in from
Cartagena.
So he's kind of tired and jet lagged and shit.
Bro.
It's fucking.
I just jumped off a jet. I'm tired,
coochie,
bro.
Coochie holes.
I just jumped off a jet.
You jumped off the jet.
Jumping off a jet.
Okay,
jumping off a jet.
Yep. Let me get some.
I just jumped off a jet. And my eyes hurt. I need to smoke a blunt, another blunt, and just knock the fuck out. Smoke a J and knock out. California shit. California love. You already know. Killer Cali. Cause she's a baddie.
Okay, here we go. Let me see. Alright, dude. Just gonna bust some raps for this shit.
I'll just do a quick quick.
Okay. Check it out. This is Gael Delarossa.
You can find my Instagram, Reekin Poppy 3. Reekin Poppy 3. Let's go. Bust me out. I'll just do a quick one. I'm tired, bro. I'm really tired. Nah. I need some new wave shit. I can't be busting with some old 90s shit.
What is
I
that?
Need some like new wave, like give me some. Yeah. All right, I guess it's some old school shit still, but I guess I can. Yeah. Is it why'd you stop it? I was about to come in. I was like, I thought you dropped the beat for a second. I was like, he dropped it. I'm like, ah. Damn, bro. I didn't do nothing. I did nothing, okay? No problem, man. Come on. Give me the beat, man. Come on, man. Long gone. Hey. Cálmate, papito.
Oh, it's just they're playing.
There's something with... Hey. What beat? Yeah, change this beat now. I ain't fucking with this. Dog, you're on the fucking cord. Oh, easy, papito. Ay, ay, ay. All right, come on. Let's do this. Sorry and sadness next to me. Just put on a beat, bro, real quick. I don't care. Just do whatever you want to put. Like, that one you had wasn't bad. I know you like the 90s shit. I don't care. As long as it's like a good beat to rhyme to. If it's like slow or too fast, I gotta just play something. I'll tell you. You like getting a little head rub, don't you? You wanna sit next to Papita?
Sit. Sit. Sit.
Calm down.
You so crazy.
He's so crazy. You're a little monster. Yeah. That beat was kind of fast. But. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Okay, that's not bad. Okay, yo. Gael Delarossa, what? Yo, it's Gael Delarossa, swinging like Sammy Sosa. Bad little baby, and I'm digging up in her chocha. I want the moolah, all of the perpetunia. I spoon ya, get cash, don't let it consume ya. I move ya, from fake niggas who talk like they would, yeah. A good man, seriously wish a nigga just would, man. A Bulls fan, MJ shit, I'm on the newsstands. I'm cool grand, that's what it takes to get a smooth chance. I lose hands, counting the people that know my tunes jam. Spoon man, relaxed and vibed in my cocoon, man. I'm booming. Niggas just trying to find what I'm doing, keep it moving. That's my motto, the life I'm choosing, I'm cruising. Life is easy when you ain't losing, I'm a student. Feel the vibes, but it's a movement, I'm prudent. Travel the world to stay affluent, what you doing? You mad at the bitches that I be pulling, you're losing. My energy's crazy, it's just oozing. You niggas mad cause you know what I'm doing. I'm that one and only guy, I stay so high. Back in the day, in my prime, did some drive-bys. Ain't my fault I'm that guy, I stay up in the sky. I'm fucking stutter, flow still smooth like butter. Calm through undercover, calm, cool, collected, motherfucker. Nigga, so ugly, your daddy should've wore a rubber. Swear to God, your mama's a sucker. In the bed sheets, your daddy, she's mad. I'm kinda get that money fast and tryna get it fast. These niggas mad cause I just stack it quickly. Motherfuckers know that I'm that number one nigga. I can stutter, the flow still smooth like butter. Care less, these niggas know I'm never hairless, nope. I'm never hairless. These niggas know that my heart's so strong, I'm fearless. Yeah, don't get me angry. These niggas better shut the fuck up. I swear to God, you don't know what my plans be.
No. Yeah, Gael Delarossa.
At the end, I kind of started fucking up, but then I caught myself again, but it's okay.
That happens. It's called Cartagena.
At least you know it's a real flow, though.
It's like called the car.
You can find me on Instagram, Rican Poppy 3, RICA.
Check out his video.
PI3.
What's that name of the video on fucking YouTube?
Oh, yeah. Gael Delarossa, Stuck in My Ways. Just type my name, Gael, G-A-E-L, and then Stuck in My Ways, and you'll find me right there.
Yeah.
No. It's lit.
Till we meet again, motherfuckers.
Thank you, Tom, for having me up on here.
Yeah, we'll do it again. We'll do it again. Do it earlier, bro.
You already know. Thanks for having me on, brother.
We always do this shit in the middle of the night. Shit, when the lights out, you got to be fucking head clear.
Yeah, we'll do it daytime early next time.
Yeah. Sounds good. Once we get some internet at the house, we can do it over there.
Get a nice coffee.
I could take this shit to your pad.
Yeah, we could do it there, too. Yeah.
Whatever.
What do you call it? You got to text me. You have my number, right?
I don't know if I do. I'll get your number right now. Give it to the world. Give it to the world.
I'm half day mama's calling me. I don't want that to
happen.
Yeah,
too much pussy sometimes. Yeah, nice. All right, man, check it out. We out of here. Fuck off, motherfuckers.
Peace.